Akash, today Dad bought 2 10-meter 40-centimeter long cloth and told us to divide it into 5 equal parts.
Okay, but in order to do so, we need to know the length of each part.
Length of each part can be found by dividing the total length, that is 10 meter 400 centimeter multiplied by 2 and then dividing it by 5. But how do we solve this?
Chitti, can you help us to solve this problem?
Sure, let me then teach you about multiplication and division on measurements of length. Today, we shall learn about multiplication on measurements of length and division on measurements of length. Earlier, you learnt about some of the commonly used units in the measurement of length. Deve, meter, kilometer, centimeter, and millimeter. We also learnt about the relation between each of these units, that is, 1 kilometer is equal to 1000 meters, 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeters, 1 centimeter is equal to 10 millimeters. There are other units like hectometer, decameter, and decimeter, which are also used. 1 decimeter is equal to 0.1 meter, and 1 decameter is equal to 10 meters, and 1 hectometer is equal to 100 meters. Consider this problem. A wagon is of length 1 meter 20 centimeters. 9 such wagons are to be attached to form a train. The length of the train is to be found. This can be solved by using the process of multiplication, which we will be learning now. Multiplication on measurement of lengths is also done in a similar way as addition and subtraction. It can also be solved by both the methods. One method is by converting all the quantities into a common unit. The other method is by writing the measurements in proper columns such that same units lie one below the other. Let us first employ the method of expressing in common units to solve this problem. In this method, all the quantities are to be expressed in a single unit. Let us express them in meters. Hence, expressing length of the wagon, 1 meter 20 centimeters is equal to 1.2 meters. Now, since all the quantities are in a common unit, we can multiply. The length of the train is equal to 1.2 into 9 is equal to 10.8 meters. Let us now employ the method of multiplication by writing quantities in proper columns to solve this problem. In this method, all the quantities are expressed in columns such that the quantities of the same unit lie one below the other. The columns are arranged in decreasing order of largeness and magnitude. Hence, meter comes before centimeter. Hence, 20 centimeters lies in the centimeter column. Now, first 9 is multiplied to the centimeter column. 9 into 20 is equal to 180 is equal to 1 meter and 80 centimeters. Carrying 1 to the left hand side and keeping 80 in the centimeters section, we now multiply 9 into 1 plus 1 is equal to 10. Hence, the solution is 10 meters and 80 centimeters. Why don't you solve some problem to understand this concept better? Akash, multiply 1 centimeter, 2 millimeters with 5.
Let us solve this by the method of arranging quantities in columns. Since centimeter is larger in magnitude than millimeter, it comes to the left. Under millimeter column, we write 2. Multiplying from the right, first we will multiply 2 into 5 is equal to 10 millimeters. 10 millimeters is equal to 1 centimeter. Hence, by carrying 1 to the left and keeping 0 in the millimeter section, now we will multiply 1 into 5 is equal to 5. And adding 1 we get 5 plus 1 is equal to 6. Hence the answer is 6 centimeters.
Very good. Now Akshara, multiply 6 kilometers, 100 meters with 4.
Let's express the quantities in a common unit. We shall express all the quantities in kilometers. Hence, 6 kilometer 100 meters is equal to 6.1 kilometers. Now, as all the measurements are expressed in the same units, we can multiply them. 6.1 multiplied by 4 is equal to 24.4 kilometers.
Very good. Consider this problem. A rod is of length 10 meters 80 centimeters and it is to be divided into 9 equal parts. The length of each part is to be found out. This can be obtained by division, which we will be learning now. Division on measurement of lengths is also done in a way similar to addition, subtraction and multiplication. It can also be solved by converting all the quantities into a common unit. Let us first employ the method of expressing in common units to solve this problem. In this method, all the quantities are to be expressed in a single unit. Let us express them in meters. 10 meters 80 centimeters is equal to 10.8 meters. As all the quantities are expressed using the same unit, we can divide. The length of the rod is equal to 10.8 divided by 9 is equal to 1.2 meters. Why don't you solve some problems to understand this concept better? Akash, divide 5 centimeters, 5 millimeters by 5.
Let's start solving by expressing quantities using the same unit, here in centimeters. We get 5 centimeters, 5 millimeters is equal to 5.5 centimeters. As all the measurements are expressed using the same units, we can divide them. 5.5 divided by 5 is equal to 1.1 centimeters.
Very good. Now, Akshara, why don't you divide 8 kilometers, 200 meters by 4?
Solve the expressing quantities in common unit. We shall express all the quantities in kilometers. Therefore, 8 kilometer 200 meters is equal to 8.2 kilometers. As all the measurements are expressed using the same units, we can divide them. 8.2 divided by 4 is equal to 2.05 kilometers.
Very good. Now that you have learnt about performing multiplication and division on measurements of length, why don't you solve the earlier problem on finding out the length of each part?
Total length of the cloth is equal to 10 meters 40 centimeters multiplied by 2. Expressing the measurements using a common unit, here in meters we get 1 centimeter is equal to 0.01 meter. Therefore, 40 centimeters is equal to 40 multiplied by 0.01, that is equal to 0.4. Hence, 10 meters 40 centimeters is equal to 10.4 meters. By multiplying, 10.4 meters into 2 is equal to 20.8 meters, which is the total length of the cloth.
Now, to find the length of each part, we need to divide the total length of the cloth by 5. That is, we must divide 20.8 meters by 5, which gives 4.16 meters. 4.16 meters is equal to 4 meters 16 centimeters. Hence, the length of each part of the cloth is 4 meters 16 centimeters.
Today, we have learnt about multiplication on measurements of length, division on measurements of length. Very good. Hope you could understand all the concepts taught today.
Yes, Chitti. Thank you very much.